The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Scheduled with Les Skymo and The Dave. Want to thank all the military. I hear that you all may be coming home from Afghanistan and different parts of the world. I hope President Trump brings you home and hopefully stop these endless wars. Want to thank the first responders, our law enforcement, EMTs, doctors, nurses. I want to thank you. I appreciate and love each and every one of you. God bless you. And God bless America. Well, folks,
Joe Biden are still at it up there. When it got dark, they started thumping people, throwing fireworks at people. Antifa and BLM did. I'd say there were like 20 arrests. Probably should have been 200. Like I say, Biden's constituency is still at it. And, folks, they thrive on this. I think what happened, Dave, is the Democrats are masters of distraction. When the cities was being burned, the stores being looted, all that mayhem going on in the street was a diversion. While that was going on, the Democrats in their respective cities and states was going through their legislatures to get these mail-in ballots approved way before the election and count them way after the election. That was these riots and all this chaos was a smokescreen for them to rig this election. There's no doubt in my mind that was a distraction so they could get this software program set up. It's out of Canada, this Dominion program. It's out of Canada, but it's been used in Venezuela. It's been used in other places, communist countries, the way I understand from Sidney Powell. And folks, I tell you, this is not sour grapes on my part. The Democrats stole this election. They lied. They cheated. They manipulated the computers, the count, and all the other things that they've done. It was in the media that was plain to see. But this ain't over yet. I'm hanging my hat on every little bit of hope that I can, because something has to be done, folks, about this. This can't continue to go on. There has to be some people in our Justice Department, our senator, somebody in authority has to step up and put a stop to this crap, the Supreme Court. The evil, David, is just rampant. It's at a height like we've never seen before. So here in just a bit, when I get your opening comments, I want to play Cindy Powell's, which was General Flynn's lawyer. I'm going to play her whole interview that she had on the Maria Bartiromo show Sunday. And I listened to her today on the Rush Limbaugh show. Mark Stein was a special guest there. As I tell you what, if she has what she says she has, and she said she don't say nothing that she can't verify, she just come right out and said today, she is going to have this election overturned.
I hope so, because, you know, there's something fishy going on when down-ballot candidates in the House, they all won. We didn't lose one House seat. We gained, what, 10 or 11, 12, something like that. But we never lost one single seat and gained seats. So House of Representatives are in the United States of America. When you go to vote as a citizen, you have a House member up for re-election every single 2 years. So it's not like that it's intermittent like the Senate. You know, you have a senator maybe in Colorado, you have one in Maine and one in North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, a couple of candidates in Georgia. Well, it's not like that. Every single jurisdiction, voting jurisdiction has a House member up every 2 years. Anytime the president's on the ballot, so is the House. And there are midterms, you've heard of midterms. What happens every in between the 4-year term of the president, it's called the midterms. 2 years from now, it'd be the midterms. But see, that's what's odd. Nobody that I know of splits the ballot like that. They don't vote against the president and vote for the House. They just don't do that. They vote mostly straight ticket. And for that to have happened, every single, I mean, it's just all these five states, for that to happen is just, it's very unusual. I just can't see it. I don't know how they did it. I mean, they did it with computers, with the software computer, you know, like you were talking about. It's possible. But as far as Trump winning the election, I don't think they're going to let him win. I don't think the courts are going to let him win. Unless they got it stone cold proof, absolute proof, there's no way they're going to. They've never done that before. They've never had another election. It's never been done. So I'm just wondering how the courts are going to handle it when the evidence is brought before them, if they're going to even want to see the evidence. I hope they do, and I hope you're right. I hope Trump does get another shot at it, but the way it looks now, it looks pretty bad.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I understand what you're saying. Nance, you just turned that off. Was it off? Okay, but anyway, folks, I'm going to, let me see if I can get this. I'm going to play this interview in its entirety. And just give me a second. But folks, I tell you, I think this is, you know, let me get all set up here. This will take a few seconds. Stay with me. Stay with me, folks. Stay with me. Since it's a little loud, I'll adjust it. I see.
That you can present this to the courts and be successful within this just couple of weeks.
Well, let me put it this way. First of all, I never say anything I can't prove. Secondly, the evidence is coming in so fast I can't even process it all. Millions of Americans.
Let me start this over, folks. I think I've got on the tail end of it. There we go.
Americans have written, I would say.
Hold on, folks.
Rewind.
That's what I'm trying to do, get to rewind. Let me shut it off. Hold on, bear with me, guys. This is the first time I've done this on air. Bear with me, turn that down a little bit. Hang with me, folks. Hang with me. This is important. I want to get this out to you. Back up, you stupid thing. Hang with me, folks. Hang with me. Here we go. It's hard to do it. Yep.
Hold this. Yes, well, he is listening to all that are behind. And this way, first of all, I never say anything I can't prove about this system. In fact, every state that bought Dominion for sure are packages for new voting machines suddenly and multiple passable is still there, and the CIA is beyond my comprehension. She should be fired and receive multiple reports of wrongdoing and failures and vulnerability
myself this weekend. And one source, who is an IT specialist,
thing I do. It never fails. Hang on. I'm going to get this, guys. I want this out there. I don't know why I shouldn't be having this kind of trouble. Should not be having this kind of trouble.
He knows the software, and specifically
I'm going to get this with the last stinking thing I do, y'all. This is the last thing I do. Hold on. All right, that's Florida. Hang on, guys. I'm a little too far there. And do it again.
Well, he is listed as its former admiral.
Hold on, folks. I can't get it to start from the beginning. I don't know what the deal is.
Admiral Peter Neffinger, retired Admiral Peter.
Why is it doing that? Stay with me, folks.
Peter Neffinger.
I'm going to get this. It's the last thing I do, folks.
What records, Dominion voting machines are used? How he fits into all of this?
I don't know. I'm frustrated with it.
Bluetooth pairing.
Hang on, folks. If it takes an hour, I'm going to get this on the air. If it takes the rest of my show to get this done. That's the video. Can you start it over and hand me your phone? This beats all over. Can you do the volume all the way up on it? Turn the volume all the way up. Can you plug this in so we'll work through the speaker. There you go. I'm going to get this, folks. Devil ain't going to win here. Here we go. How we go.
And according to public records, Dominion voting machines are used in 2,000 jurisdictions in 30 states. According to experts, if one site has a flaw, other sites are likely to as well, which is why Texas rejected using Dominion software 3 times, raising concerns that the system was not safe from fraudulent or unauthorized violation. That's troubling, given we already know that at least 2 software glitches in Georgia and Michigan occurred on election night. Attorney Sidney Powell is leading the charge against Dominion, and she says she has enough evidence of fraud to launch a massive criminal investigation. Sidney, thanks very much for being here. We appreciate your time this morning. I want to get right into it. We just heard about the software made by Smartmatic from Rudy, and I want to...
Yes, well, he is listed as its former Admiral Peter Neffinger, or retired Admiral Peter Neffinger. He is president and on the board of directors of Smartmatic, and it just so happens he's on Mr. Biden's presidential transition team that's going to be non-existent because we're fixing to overturn the results of the election in multiple states, and President Trump won by not just hundreds of thousands of votes, but by millions of votes that were shifted by this software that was designed expressly for that purpose. We have sworn witness testimony
of why the software was designed. It was designed to rig elections. He was fully briefed on it. He saw it happen in other countries. It was exported internationally for profit by the people that are behind Smartmatic and Dominion. They did this on purpose. It was calculated. They've done it before. We have evidence from 2016 in California. We have so much evidence, I feel like it's coming in through a fire hose.
Wow. So should they, you feel that you will be able to prove this? Do you have the software in your possession? Do you have the hardware in your possession? How will you prove this, Sydney?
Well, I've got lots of ways to prove it, Maria, but I'm not going to tell on national TV what all we have. I just can't do that.
Okay, but you have a small time frame here. The elections are supposed to be certified in early December. Do you believe that you can present this to the courts and be successful within this just couple of weeks?
Well, let me put it this way. First of all, I never say anything I can't prove. Secondly, the evidence is coming in so fast, I can't even process it all. Millions of Americans have written, I would say by now, definitely hundreds of thousands have stepped forward with their different experiences of voter fraud. But this is a massive election fraud, and I'm very concerned it involved not only Dominion and its Smartmatic software, but that the software essentially was used by other election machines also. It's the software that was the problem. Even their own manual explains how votes can be wiped away. They can put, it's like drag and drop Trump votes to a separate folder and then delete that folder. It's absolutely brazen how people bought this system and why they bought this system. In fact, every state that bought Dominion for sure should have a criminal investigation or at least a serious investigation of the officers in the states who bought the software. We've even got evidence of some kickbacks, essentially.
Kickbacks. I want to take a short break and come back on that. Welcome back. We are back with attorney Sidney Powell, who's part of President Trump's legal team. Sidney, before we went to the break, we talked about, you said that there may have been kickbacks to some people who accepted the Dominion software. Tell me what you mean.
Well, I mean, we are collecting evidence now from various whistleblowers that are aware of substantial sums of money being given to family members of state officials who bought the software. I mean, we're talking about $100 million packages for new voting machines suddenly in multiple states, and benefits ranging from financial benefits for family members to sort of what I would call election insurance. Because they know that they can win the election if they are using that software. It's really an insidious, corrupt system, and I can't tell you how livid I am with our government for not paying attention to complaints even brought by Democrats, Carolyn Maloney, Elizabeth Warren, Amy Klobuchar, over the last several years in written letters with expert reports and some documentation of how corrupt this software is, and nobody in our government has paid any attention to it, which makes me wonder how much the CIA has used it for its own benefit in different places, and why Gina Haspel is still there in the CIA is beyond my comprehension. She should be fired immediately.
Which governor or which government official accepted hundreds of millions of dollars in benefits for their family as they took on this software?
If I said hundreds of millions of dollars there, I misspoke. I don't know the exact amount of money yet. We are still collecting the evidence on that, but it's more than one.
Okay, so you can't say who you believe took kickbacks. What is the CIA's role? Why do you think Gina Haspel should be fired immediately? You're saying that the CIA is behind the Dominion or Smartmatic voting software as well?
Well, the CIA and the FBI and other government organizations have received multiple reports of wrongdoing and failures and vulnerabilities in this company's product. Their own manual, if you sat down and read it, would explain how and why no honest person would use this system. And it's not just Dominion. There are other companies in the voting machine business in this country, too, that may very well and are likely using the same software. We've detected voting irregularities that are inexplicable and align with these problems in other states that think they have valid systems. But the people who bought the Dominion system for sure knew exactly what they were getting. It should never have been installed anywhere. And we are going to show the public exactly how rotten the entire state is.
Now, I have spoken with a few whistleblowers myself this weekend, and one source who is an IT specialist told me that he knows the software and specifically advised people in Texas, officials in Texas, not to use it. And yet, he was overruled. He said that there was an unusual patch that was put into the software while it was live, and it's highly unusual to put a patch in there. Is that what you're referring to? Tell me how it's done and how these back doors work.
Okay, that's part of it. They can stick a thumb drive in the machine or upload software to it, even from the internet. They can do it from Germany or Venezuela even. They can remote access anything. They can watch votes in real time. They can shift votes in real time. We've identified mathematically the exact algorithm they used and plan to use from the beginning to modify the votes in this case to make sure Biden won. That's why he said, yeah, he didn't need your votes now. He would need you later. He was right. I mean, in his demented state, he had no filter, and he was speaking the truth more than once, including when he said he had the largest voter fraud organization ever. Well, it's massive election fraud. It's going to undo the entire election. And they can do anything they want with the votes. They can have the machines not read the signature. They can have the machines not read the down ballot. They can make the machines read and catalog only the Biden votes. It's like drag and drop, whatever you want, wherever you want, upload votes.
Yeah.
In fact, we've got math in Michigan and Pennsylvania, I think it is, that all of a sudden, hundreds of thousands of votes at a 67% ratio for Biden, 23% for Trump, were uploaded multiple times into the system.
And Sydney, you say you have an affidavit from someone who knows how this system works and was there with the planning of it. You believe you can prove this?
Yes. Oh, yes. We have essentially a sworn statement from a witness who knew exactly how it worked from the beginning, why it was designed to work that way, and saw when things started shutting down and they started, stopped counting the votes here. That was the same play that had worked in other countries.
Wow. This is explosive, and we certainly will continue to follow it. Sydney, thank you so much for your work. We will be catching up with you soon. Thanks so much.
I think they could do forensics on these and find out if what she said is true. They can do forensics and find out. The FBI can track this down to see how all this worked. I hope they do investigate it thoroughly.
It seems overwhelming, David, to where they're going to be forced to have to. You turn your mic on, brother.
Yeah.
It sounds to me like that she's got overwhelming evidence that not even the deep state and the FBI or CIA can sweep this under the rug. She has got a sworn affidavit from somebody that was in on the planning on how to steal this election. How do you beat that?
See, I think that's why Biden wasn't too concerned about getting out of the basement all summer. He knew it was in the bag. He knew it was in the bag. Because he got word that that's exactly what they were going to do, and that's exactly what they did. That's the only thing that explains the down ballot success the Republicans had in the election. That would totally explain the down ballot.
Right.
Why would anybody split the vote and vote against vote for a Biden than vote for the Republican House members or Senate. It makes no sense. It just doesn't make any sense at all. You know, I think Joe Biden told a moment of truth there when he confessed they had the greatest voter fraud organization of all time. I think he was speaking candidly and openly, and he forgot what he was saying because his mind's about, as Trump would say, he's shot.
Right.
He's totally shot, but he actually went through a moment of clarity and truth. He actually told what happened.
Yeah. Folks on Facebook, if you're watching on Facebook, if you couldn't hear that, sorry about all the trouble. I didn't anticipate as usual. But that very same video is on my page, Go to Les Skymo, on my Facebook page. And you can listen to this same thing that I just played. Folks, you can go to Armed Radio Group News and you can get a full lineup of our shows. This is Les Skymo and The Dave. You can also download the TuneIn app. Our programs are archived on iHeartRadio, Spotify. I don't know if my 1-800 number is working or not, so I can get somebody to call it to see if it's working. And if it is, I'll give that number out. If it's not, well, then there's another week without it. And but anyway, Dave, Sidney Powell reminds me of Margaret Thatcher for some reason.
And, yeah, she does.
You know, she does. And I think she is, I know that she's a very tenacious lawyer. She has sunk her teeth into this. She's a pretty straight shooter, brother. And I think that she's one of them lawyers that, she's straight up. She's honest. She wants the law obeyed.
I'll tell you what, if she's successful, this will be the greatest fraud ever perpetrated on the American public of all time.
Do you think this outdo Obama, Ben Kenyon?
Oh yeah, this outdoes everything. As far as I'm concerned, this is the biggest fraud ever perpetrated on the American public.
Yeah,
I always thought. I think about this for a second. Remember back in the before the election, weeks before the election, there was a poll that came out. And they said like 57% of the American people thought they were better off today, even after the pandemic, than they were after Obama and Biden regime.
Mm-hmm.
So think about that for a second. That's a big majority there. 57% thought we were better off today, even through the pandemic. Now, how could it be that Trump got beat?
Right.
Trump couldn't even believe it. He said, can you believe it? I'm getting beat by this guy.
Right.
You know, In all of his rallies, he was saying, this is unbelievable. How in the world could Sleepy Joe beat Donald Trump? Just no way.
Right.
I know there were shenanigans going on, but as for the exact way to prove it, I hope that they can, because this thing is massive.
Right.
This is massive.
Right.
And this is going to take the Supreme Court.
Things.
It's going to have to be redone. For all the states that use that software, they're going to have to revote.
Right.
That's the way it's going to have to be.
Right.
Because if they use that software and they cheated and they can prove it, I'll tell you what, there's no alternative but those five states. The states that use it will have to vote again.
Right.
That's the only way you can remedy this.
Yeah.
That's the only remedy I can see, is those states that use the software will have to revote. Now, the other states, like Florida and Texas and all the states that didn't use the software, they're going to... They're all their facts and figures will stand.
Yeah.
All their vote count will stand. But this has to be remedied. There's no way you can go. I mean, and not let it go on. It can't go on like this. This United States of America. We don't have crooked elections. We don't do like the banana republics down in Venezuela or someplace. It's interesting to note that I heard that this company actually changed its Wikipedia, because they said that they used their software had been used in Venezuela.
Yeah,
Now, what does that tell you? They're a bunch of cheaters down there. They cheat all the time, and all these other countries that they cheated. Every country that's a banana republic used this software, and now they brought it to the United States. This is totally impossible. This has to be. This has to be fixed.
I think she's got the goods, Dave. I know. Now, people out there, I know you're frustrated. I understand the disappointment. I myself was distraught. But there was also, David, unbelief. How could Pennsylvania and Michigan and these other states that depend on coal, depend on oil, depend on the natural resources to provide thousands and thousands of jobs. How could these states vote for an environmental program that will bankrupt this country?
I don't know.
You know? And it don't make sense, Dave. Mathematically, 500,000 votes come in, and what, just a few, if any, for President Trump? There's so many irregularities in this. there's too many coincidences for it to not be on purpose. And it just blows my mind that folks, my 1-800 number is not working. So,
well, the biggest thing is the United States of America has seen evidence of this thing the night of the election.
Before.
Now, remember, you watch the election, you remember this. You're watching at 10:30 at night, and you say, oh, man, Trump's smoking him. He's going to win easy. I was feeling really good. I was feeling great, man. 10:30 at night, I'm feeling really good. All the figures, all the votes are coming in, everybody's doing their projections and all that. And then all of a sudden, around 11 o'clock, everything stopped. It crashed. Everything stopped. And I'm thinking, what's going on here? I mean, Trump's on his way to a big victory. Why is everything stopped? Well, we know now. They were rejiggering all the figures,
right,
and redoing all the. That's how 100,000 votes could come in with no Trump votes, just all Biden votes. One big chunk of 100,000 votes come in for Biden. That's impossible.
The algorithm,
that can't happen. You know good and well that at least Trump would have 5,000 or 6,000 people out of 100,000 that would vote for him. That's ridiculous.
Absolutely.
That's absolutely ridiculous.
Right.
They cheated, blatantly cheated, and they expect us to believe it.
But all the corruption. Okay, number one, that's why they were so scared of President Trump's war. They knew that he was going to come in and change things. They didn't understand the degree. Because really, not even me, or I don't think you or anybody else, knew what kind of candidate, what kind of president Trump would actually be. We never really knew his politics, Dave. Okay, the more he talked when he was campaigning, the more we learned about him. We really didn't know, because all I knew that he was from, other than his TV shows, was he fraternized and rubbed elbows with Democrats his whole career. All the time he's working, you know, is he pro-life? Is he pro-choice? Come to find out, he used to be a pro-choice Democrat. And now he comes out as this superman of a conservative and law and order man. And he's tearing up their playhouse. They're scared to death of him. Now, after a while, they figured it out. They knew that he was going after them. To drain the swamp thing, that spooked them, Dave. That scared them. But you go back to Lois Lerner, all right, under Obama, what she done to them conservative groups through the IRS and what Obama, the controversy around Obama, that he wasn't vetted. And you can thank John McCain, the songbird, for that. But, oh, no, don't worry about it. He's an American. And then Joe Arpaio done a multi-million dollar, him and Mike Zulu, done an in-depth investigation on Barack Obama's birth certificate, who he was. They used two forensic experts, one in Italy and one in America, and neither one of them knew what the other one was doing, and they both come down with the same results, and you still have the Kenyan listed as a former president and was elected twice. They have gotten away with so much corruption, David. They have gotten away with so many criminal acts that they had to do, and they had to get rid of President Trump. But they were so blatant, and they really didn't. They went through with this election fraud just knowing that nobody, if they did figure it out, that nobody would pick it up. Nobody would want to investigate it. Nobody would care. Just like some of our own Republicans, Dave. Oh, just accept it and move on. Just concede and move on. How many Republicans are saying that right now? That just go along to get along, Republicans. Just concede and just move on. I thank God President Trump is fighting this, because, David, if Sidney Powell pulls this off and the truth comes out and all this corruption is exposed, brother, you talk about restructuring our political system in America. You talk about the death knell in the Democrat and, the, most importantly, the socialist communist Democrats in this country. Brother, that'll drive a stake right through the heart of these evil devils that's trying to destroy this country. You talk about Russia collusion. Who was doing the colluding? I hang my hat on this, Dave. I really do, because Sidney Powell is not one to, she's a kind of like a Rudy Giuliani, you know, and when the truth is uncovered, then they start calling them names and start victimizing them, and the same old crap the Democrats always do. Well, David, I tell you what, brother, this flag's going to hang behind us, even regardless of what happens. I haven't even took my yard signs down, and I'm not going to until I find out exactly who our president is. Joe Biden will never, never, never be a legitimate president in my eyes, David, because they stole this. It's obvious. It don't add up. It's mathematically impossible. A lot of the things that went on, and there's just no way.
Well, I just look at it this way. Trump should have done at least as well as he did last election.
Yeah.
Because if you look at all of his rallies that he had, the rallies were twice, two times, three times bigger than they were the first time in 16. So you would think, well, since he's doing much more popular in the rallies, and he went to virtually the same places for his rallies as he did in 2016. Matter of fact, he finished at the exact same spot this time around than he did in 2016 in Michigan. But think about that for a second. How in the world can somebody have a rally and have 15 circles out there, and mostly reporters filled in the circles, a parking lot full of, 90 cars honking their horn, looking like a traffic jam, and Biden's giving some kind of a stupid speech where he can't even remember anything without looking at the teleprompter. And you compare that to Trump, and you think, oh, wait a minute now, Trump got beat by this guy? It just doesn't make any sense. It just doesn't make any sense at all. The common average person, now, say if a Martian came from Mars and they landed in the United States, and they looked at all the campaigning was going on, they'd have to say, well, this Trump guy is going to be the big winner here. But, you know, according to what we know about elections, but that's not the way it went down. And I think they knew it from the get-go that the fix was in, because the way that Biden was acting.
Right.
Biden, he didn't care if he went out or not. He stayed in his basement. He didn't care because he didn't have to. Everything hung on nothing that Trump could do or Biden could do could change the results. The results were already in the mix. Everything was in the mix. And they knew that they were going to cheat. And they did. And they pulled it off, and that's exactly what happened. They cheated, and they got away with it, at least so far. But this is going to go down in history. If it's not changed, it's going to be one of the biggest scandals of all time.
Oh, yeah, there's no doubt about it. And you know, I've talked to several different people. Oh, I'll never vote again. This is it. Now, I know in Ohio, we knew our election was, it was counted. What, before midnight, by midnight, maybe a little after. But anyway, I understand how you feel.
Before I forget about it, Lex, think about this. Remember all the polls that came out before the election. Biden winning by a huge amount. Now, that was to prepare us for the cheating that was going on. Yeah. I think that's, they knew that. And so all the cheating that was going on, they prepared the way for that by saying that Biden was going to win by 6, 7, 8 points.
Yeah.
And that's exactly why they said that, because they knew it wasn't true. It wasn't true. There's no way it could have been true. Look at all the House members. We didn't lose one single House seat.
Picked some up.
Well, we picked up 10, 12, 13. I don't know. It's not over yet, but we picked up. Everybody said, oh, you're going to lose House seats. It didn't happen. See, that's why they didn't cheat on the, they didn't cheat down ballot. They only cheated for president. It was a lot easier and took less time to run the ballots back through the machines again and only ink out the presidential slot. You can't go down the down ballot and ink all those. Look how long it would take you to do that many ballots if you inked in all of, I don't know about any other state, but our state, we use optical scanner system here, and we have to fill in the little circle, the oval. We have to color it in with either pencil or ink pen. And then it goes to a machine that scans that darkened area, and it knows where that area is, like a computer, and it tallies the vote automatically. So optical scanning system primarily is what is used throughout the United States. It's all pretty much the same. So when you've got people cheating and they're running ballots through, all they got time to do is vote for president. They don't have time to do the down ballot one. Have to scribble that in, run it through, scribble another one, run it through, scribble it in. It's because each one of these has a little stub on it. And the stubs have to match the number that, of the ballots that go through the machine. You remember turning your stub in, right?
Right. Yeah.
You had to pull the stub off the bottom.
Right.
It went in a separate box. Then the vote went through the machine. We scanned it ourselves and went through and scanned. So all this has to be done fast. So that's why everything stopped. Because Trump was winning, and so whoa, we got to stop everything. We got to fix this. And that's exactly what they did. They stopped it. They said, and this claimed that some people had to go home because they were tired.
Well, one state, it was all night long.
Yeah, they said, oh, we got to go home. We're tired.
All right,
we'll start back tomorrow.
Yeah.
Since when is that? That doesn't. That's laughable.
Right. If you didn't prepare to count votes all night long. And not only that, Dave, it only happened in the battleground states and the battleground counties and the battleground cities like Detroit and Philadelphia. You know, so it's obvious on its face what happened, you know. And you know, the reason I wanted to bring this to you, I was tickled to death to hear this. I'm trying to breed a little bit of hope out there. And I understand, you know, like I said, I've talked to people that say, I'll never vote again. My vote don't count. I understand that. But here's the thing. That's exactly what they want you to do, Dave. They want to beat you down. They want to discourage you from even participating. They want you not to fight.
That's what the polling was all about.
It's easier for them if you don't fight back.
That's what the polling was all about.
You know?
They wanted to discourage you, make you think, well,
exactly.
Why should I go out and vote? Trump's going to lose anyway.
Yeah. Because
he's so far behind. He's there's no way he can win. But you see, they did it with polling, and then they did it with the cheating and the voting. And, I mean, anybody with half a brain can see what they did.
Yeah.
They were up to no good from the get-go.
Right. It doesn't take a genius to figure this out.
I think Biden knew it, and he's so
I think
far,
you're right.
He's so far shot that he actually admitted to it.
Well,
he forgot the lie.
And they just write it off.
But he actually told the truth, I think.
I do.
You've heard of a Freudian slip. Well, that's the ultimate Freudian slip right there. He slipped out and told the truth. Because his mind's not working right. Anybody can tell his mind is not right. He's not totally there all the time. And when he just said that, the greatest, we're involved in the greatest
election fraud
of all time. Yeah. Something to that effect. He said,
"Election fraud team. We've got the largest election fraud team."
Yeah, the greatest election fraud. That was amazing when he said that.
Yeah.
Everybody said, "Ah, that's just Joe." I think he was just telling the truth. He actually knew what was going on, and he was telling the truth.
Right. Well, and you know, and you mentioned this you mentioned this at the Veterans Dinner, that's why Joe was so cool about laying back and not doing nothing. Kamala, you didn't see her out there taking up the slack, did you?
No, she didn't go anywhere.
You didn't see any of these. Every once in a while, you'd see.
They didn't have to.
You know.
That's because they knew they didn't have to.
Wasn't that strange, though? When you sit and think about it, ain't that funny? Ain't that strange?
You put yourself in that position. It's like going up to a card table. You know the cards are stacked.
Yeah.
And you know that you're going to get, say you're playing blackjack or some game, you know you're going to get every face card and every ace. And you're going to get blackjack after blackjack. Because you know, and you're not worried. And that's why you can bet as much money as you want, because you know that you're going to win. And that's exactly what happened here. They knew they were going to win.
Right. Yeah.
And that's what happened.
That's the only explanation for that. Okay. And it goes right down to the yard signs. How many Biden yard signs did you see?
In my neighborhood, zero.
Yeah. Everywhere I went,
I had my yard sign up. The neighbor next to me had his, or not Biden, but Trump sign up. The neighbor two doors down had a Trump sign. And down the street there was another Trump sign. So there was at least four or five in my surrounding neighborhood. And I didn't see one Biden sign.
Yeah. There may be 75 houses, maybe 60 in my complex where I live here. Not one Biden sign. Everywhere you drove around here, you might see one out of 1,000 homes, maybe, that had a Biden. But well, I say all that, and, you know, people say, well, you can't really depend on that. I mean, that's a sign, though, Dave.
Well, the way it went the last time,
you know,
didn't it?
Yeah. It's.
Why can't you? Mm-hmm. I mean, it's anecdotal evidence, but
the thing is,
Warren County is This is actually Trump country. I mean, there's not that many Biden voters here.
Yeah,
you take us and Butler and part of Hamilton County, the northern part of Hamilton County, and you take those counties, and this overwhelmingly is a red area.
Right,
but then you have to go to outskirts of Columbus and then Cleveland,
Cincinnati
before you get. Into Biden country.
Right.
That's what they do. See, they take up the highest population areas. And another thing is about the vote. It was a record turnout. And I just can't see how in the world could Joe Biden get 77 million votes?
Yeah.
How could he possibly get 77 million votes?
How can he do
it? You never saw him. I mean, the guy never campaigned, but yet he got 77 million votes. And you can't tell me that people were all voting against Trump.
Right.
I just don't believe that.
It don't add up, David. See, then that's what Sydney was talking about. She's got these mathematicians that crunch all these numbers and these odds and the mathematical possibilities of these things. And, it's just impossible for what took place to happen in reality. There had to be something to influence what happened. And we know what it is. It was a Dominion voting program. These machines was tampered with this But the software that was put in them, Dave, is the only explanation this was stolen.
She said that that software patch was actually being used
while
it was live.
Yeah.
Active. That's just plain crazy.
Hey, you don't even do that on my own computer.
Yeah, I don't know how they figured it up or how they rigged it up, but I know they rigged it somehow.
It was rigged, brother. There's no two ways about it. And she's on it.
FBI should be able to figure out how to do forensics on the machines and figure out what happened.
Well, like I said a long time ago, where's the Justice Department? Now, Barr, he did poke his head out of this hole and give his prosecutors permission to follow up on these accusations. So, there's more investigations. You know, where would have been investigations after Yang Yang, but nobody's went to prison yet. And I'm as frustrated as anybody else. But, you know, to me, I'm hanging my hat on Sydney's pals, what she said. I think she can be trusted. And she knows what she has. And a lot of things, folks, we just barely, she just released barely information, just enough to let us know, to give us a little bit of hope, David. And you know, like I said, I heard her on the Russia's show today, and she, you know, just from yesterday to today, she ain't missed a beat. And Rudy Giuliani, he's on the case. He's got all kinds of evidence. So, folks, Dave, I know we're up against the timeline here with getting these elections certified. However, a stay can be put on that. Okay. Excuse me. Oh, pardon me, old bitch.
Any judge is going to look at those on January the 20th at 12 noon. There has to be a swearing in.
Or it goes to the House of Representatives.
If it's not solved by then, it's going to be by, they can't figure it out. They can't get the evidence, and the court refuses to hear her for some reason. Biden's going to be sworn in. There's no doubt about it.
Well, there's 4 out of the 9 justices has to agree to take a case.
I think you'd probably get that.
Yeah. And, you know.
John Roberts turned into a Democrat.
Roberts?
He's turned into, I don't know what.
Yeah. I hear he's been blackmailed. He's another Jeff Sessions in my book. He's another Mitt Romney in my book. He's a failure. And as far as I'm concerned, there's something very shady with that man. When this is all said and done, and Trump's put back in office, or when President Trump is reelected, however it goes, or even with another Republican president, there needs to be an investigation on Chief Justice John Roberts. But there's something very nefarious going on there. There's something fishy, because he sure takes the Democrats' side a lot on some of these cases, his decisions. I don't trust the man no further than I can throw him. Maybe W knew who he was and what he was and what he would do before he put him on the Supreme Court. You know, but the bottom line to it, folks, is I've said this before, and it's deeper than what I realized, David. The swamp is more corrupt than I could have ever imagined. Could you imagine having to wade through that swamp like President Trump has done all this time and have to deal with these villains, these crime families? You know, and the hatred and all the, you know, things that he's had to put up with, but yet he's still willing to fight. He's still willing to do what he can to see that what is right is done. Because, David, It's simple as this, brother. The future of America not only hangs in the balance with this election, but over the voter fraud. If this is not nipped in the bud, if this is not brought to a righteous end, America is doomed a lot faster than what she was going to go down. Because this can't stand, Dave.
I think all this mail-in ballot stuff was just a smokescreen for the cheating.
We'll flood the
market with the ballots. Then they won't be able to trace them down, track them down. Because of the vast volume, they won't be able to figure out how we cheated.
Right. So
that's exactly what they did. Right. They wanted everybody to vote, as many could vote as possible, so they could cheat.
Yeah.
They put many ballots out there as they possibly could. And that's exactly
what
they did.
Yeah.
And they'll do it again.
Yeah.
They'll probably do it in Georgia.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's just like the looting and the burning. When all that was going on, they was laying the foundation for this right here. I really believe that, Dave. And nothing will change my mind on this. But, folks, I know, you know, I sympathize with everybody. But we're Trumpsters. Okay, we've had the greatest president, David, that me and you have ever had in our lifetime. I'm not going to abandon the man. I'm not going to throw my hands up and quit. I'm just as frustrated and heartbroken as anybody else over this. But I'm a fighter, you know. I'm not going to walk away and let evil win and my voice never be heard no more. Or that ballot never punched no more. That's what they want to do. They want to beat us down and discourage us so bad that we just engage from the fight, but that we just quit, but we throw in the towel. David, I tell you, I'm not made that way. I don't function that way. You got to beat me down and keep me from getting up. And you know, I'm getting back up. I'm staying in the fight. I will vote next time comes around.
And, Trump 2024.
You know, Trump 2024. He'll be 78 years old. But hey, if he's as sharp as he is today,
as old as Sleepy Joe is now,
you know, and he's got my vote. His family members have my vote. If any of his sons run, you know, and but I'm there, brother, you know, and but I'm not going to give them what they want and just lay down and let them have my vote. Too many people died, too many people bled, too many people give limbs and lives and fortunes, okay, for that one vote. And nothing's sacred to the Democrats. We already know that, David. Life don't mean nothing to them unless it's their own life, okay, and they want, you know.
Hey, Les, we're over time here.
Yeah. All right, we're over time. All right, folks, well, we're out of here. This is Les Skymona, David. We'll see you next week. Take us out, David. Revolution, revolution, gun control, the sound of soul. Shooting rockets to the moon, kids going up too soon. Politicians say more taxes will solve everything. And the band plays.